Hello everyone, myself R.C. Biradar, working as an assistant professor in WIT Solapur. In this video lecture, we are going to learn about the development of the lateral surface of a right cylinder. At the end of this session, students will be able to draw the lateral surface of a right cylinder. Introduction. Development. It is the plane figure of a 3D object we get after unrolling the 3D object on the development plane. So it can be done by using three different methods. First one is parallel line method, second one is radial line method, third one is triangulation method that is used for polyhedron. In first method, cylinder and prisms will be done, and here this figure is called a cylinder and this one is called as prism. A cylinder is having an external surface as curved surface, and here we have imaginary lines on the cylinder surface called generators or elements. And we need to keep a cylinder on the development plane so that one element is on the development plane, and we need to unroll the cylinder surface up to the last so that all the elements or generators are on the development plane, and that will be the development of the lateral surface of a cylinder. In that figure, we get all the elements are parallel to each other. So it is called as parallel line method. And similarly, for the prism also, we get, once we unroll all the vertical surfaces of a prism on the development plane, we get plane figure as a rectangle having all the elements or vertical edges are parallel to each other. Second method, radial line method, it is used for cone and pyramid. So these imaginary lines on the curved surface of cone are called as generators or elements. And the base of a cone is a circle, right circle. And here we need to keep a cone on the development plane such that one element is on the development plane. And after that, we need to unroll the cone surface on the development plane so that all the elements or generators are on the development plane. So that figure is called as development of the cone. Here, if you see that one side of all the elements are having the vertex as their origin, and this is the another end. So these all the elements are radiating from the origin, that is center. So that figure is called as the development of the cone. And similarly, we can have the development for pyramid also in the same fashion. Third method, triangulation method, it is used for polyhedrons and wrapped surfaces. So for example, triangular pyramid and tetrahedron. And this method is used for the objects which are having triangular surfaces. In this figure, we can see that a pentagonal prism is having two pentagonal surfaces. One is at the top surface and another is at the bottom surface. And since it is having five corners or five edges, we connect this edge with this rectangle surface. So similarly, we have five vertical surfaces. And in this second figure, if you see this, so this edge is open, means this vertical edge is cut so that all the five vertical surfaces can be arranged on a development plane. So we get 2D object. So the length of this rectangle plane is equal to the five times the edge of the pentagon. And the height of this line is equal to the height of the axis or height of the prism. And these two pentagonal surfaces we get because two surfaces are there, in one is in the top and another in the bottom, and this surface is called as a pentagonal prism development. Similarly, for cylinder also, in the second figure we get this figure here, this generator is cut here. So here we have two circles, and if you unroll the curved surface of the cylinder on the development plane, we get it as a rectangular surface of this line, length equal to pi into d, that is circumference of the circle, and the height of this rectangle is equal to the axis height or the cylinder height. So this plane is called as development of the cylinder, full cylinder. So we take one example. So in this example, we are going to take a cylinder which is resting on HP with its base. So we get the true shape of the circle on the top view, that is on the HP plane. In the VP plane, we get the front view of the cylinder. So here the cylinder I have taken as a truncated cylinder. Truncated cylinder means it is cut using the cutting plane. So here the cutting plane is inclined with HP at an angle of 45 degree with HP, and the cutting plane is passing through the axis below the top surface by 25 mm. That we are going to see here. And the total height of the cylinder is 65 mm, and that is equal to the axis height. And without truncated, if the cylinder is full, we get this rectangle, that is PAAPP, rectangle for full cylinder. And so we need to cut or divide this circle by 8 times, any equal number of parts, 8 or 12. So in the top view, we get two circles here. So both are coinciding each other. One is for bottom surface and another is for the top surface. So we need to name the bottom surface with PQRSTUW and the top view by and the top circle by ABCD up to H. Since the cylinder is truncated here, so the front view looks like this. And these lines are called as generators. So these are projected from this top view points from A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. And this can be projected here. So here we get two generators. And this stretch out line must be divided by 8 parts because we have taken 8 number of divisions here and name them. And connect this with the top points also. And these are called as generators on the development plane. And we get this point of intersection with the generator and the cutting plane. So this here we get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here one more 6, 7, 8. So here we get 2 points because here we have 2 generators. And here we have 1 generator, so we have 1 point. Now, to get the development of the truncated cylinder, we need to transfer these points on these lines or generators. So transfer these all 8 points on this development. So on the respect to generator. So first point is we get here and here also, because this first point is on PA generator. So in this PA is line here is here and one more PA line is here. So we get this as point 1. Similarly, second point number 2. So here we get on generator QB and point number 8 on WH because both are on same height. Similarly, 3 and 7, 4 and 6 and 5 point. We can project on this development plane. And once we get all these points of intersection, so connect these points with a curved profile because the cylinder is having the curved profile. So once we cut, we get the profile as curved. So we need to connect all these points with the curved surface and this. So now this dark plane is called as development of the truncated cylinder. Now in this case, I have taken cutting plane is inclined with HP by 45 degree. Now, so this is the development plane we get. So if you can think that if the cutting plane is inclined by 30 degree, whether we get the same profile of the truncated cylinder or what? This is a reference plane I used. Thank you.